princess_rose_prettydamsel,
chidi_goddess, and together
we're the Encamp Girls. Hashtag Chidi Fashions.
Retro touch with the swag, it was good as the music.
Welcome back to our channel, everyone, boys and girls, men and women, elders, babies,
elderly,
everybody,
children.
Welcome back, introverts, extroverts.
Yes,
all of you.
Introverts.
We're all welcome.
Introvert.
Everybody.
Extrovert. Introvert. Welcome back to our channel. We've missed you guys actually.
Yeah,
and yeah, welcome back if you haven't subscribed. For those of you that haven't subscribed,
we know.
Back.
We know that allows us to pray for you.
Seriously, because we have some prayer warriors here. So subscribe to our channel if you haven't subscribed. And if you're unsubscribed, go back
subscribe
and do
back.
Alright, welcome back, y'all.
Yes, and guys, for today's video, we just wanted to talk about something that we get asked a lot, and that is, how do we balance owning a business and our regular life, like our regular schedules? We have work, some of us have school, and then we're pastor's children, so we have like a lot of commitment in the church.
Mm-hmm.
Every event that the church plans, we are the event planners. So if you need somebody to plan your event,
which is a lot of events.
Yeah, so if you need someone to plan your event, you can hit us up. We have a lot of
she has a website though.
Yeah,
we got you.
So yeah, so how do we balance all that with the business that we own? It's a small business. We do not have any other employees. It's just us. So how do we get together to make sure that the business keeps running, products are being made and shipped out to people and things like that? So we just wanted to share that. It's tips that will help. These are tips that's going to help you no matter what business that you do. It's not just for retail or clothing business. It will really help regardless of the business that you're doing, or if it's even if it's a side business that you're just starting, how you can balance that off and kind of help you not be overwhelmed or just break down. So I guess like one of the tips that I'm gonna start off with is if you own a business, you have to realize that it's a 24-hour business. So it's not like you say, oh, I'm only gonna do this business a certain time. Like, no, it's 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. Whenever that you have free time, do what you have to do. No matter how small, even though it's 1 hour, 30 minutes, if you don't get to finish it, then whatever
Everybody
time
counts.
Yeah, you do, you keep going. So don't think like, oh, I have to map out time in my schedule. No, like if today you happen to have 2 hours, an hour, 30 minutes, do something for your business in that time, and then whenever time presents itself again, you can also do that as well. So that's one tip. No, having the mindset that it's 24 hours, 7 days a week.
Yeah. I'm gonna piggyback off of you before saying what I want to say.
Mm-hmm.
I actually just saw a post right before this on Instagram that said 9 to 5 you work your job, and then from 6 to 10 or 12 you build your empire.
Mm-hmm.
So it's like, for those of us like me, I just finished school. Ha ha ha, it's a graduate.
I
was waiting for it.
Thank God.
So like if you had school or if you had work, right? So we understand like you can't quit your job because you know you need means of income, or you need to study and get your education.
Right.
But in that time, yes, you do your thing, but you're not in school 12 hours or 24 hours a day. So once you get off of school or from work, just make sure that you're actually being productive with
even
the rest
on your
of the
way
time
to school,
that you have.
Like
left.
You could do like on your way to school or your way to work, you could do like the things that are mobile, like if it's like updating your social media, updating your website or whatever that the case might be.
Mm-hmm.
You could do that on your way to wherever you were going. And you know, things that don't require you to be at home or in the office, those things you can do on your way to certain places. I have to also have to like confess, when I go to certain events, like, and I'm just sitting there, like those events that don't require you to be doing anything but sit there, I do business stuff during that time too. Like it's like I'm sitting there just looking or watching, and I could just use my use the iPad and like do stuff during that time as well.
Yeah, so the gist is like not using work or like events as an excuse, but actually like making it intentional about finding time to doing the things that are important to you. What was I gonna say?
Your own tip.
Oh yeah. my own point, something that have helped me with balancing everything, like with school and work and you know the business, is writing things down. Writing things down helps me a lot. Like even my friends will tell you, like for projects, assignments, everything, I write it down and it helps me it keeps me organized and it helps me know, okay, like this hasn't been done yet, or okay, like I'll do this Monday, I'll do this Tuesday, or I won't have time for this, I'll push it to next week, or this is due first, I'm gonna do this first. So that helps you like prioritize one deadlines mm-hmm. and keeps you like on day on what needs to be done. If stuff needs to be shipped out like yesterday, okay, I need to do that first. Mm-hmm. So writing things down is something that has helped. It has also helped like keep things on a timeline.
No matter how good you yeah. are, you're gonna forget.
Yeah.
Like you can't
even
have
the littlest things yeah. you think you won't forget, but you forget. Yeah, so just writing things down is a very good
thing. Then you just check it off as you go.
Yeah.
And you could do it on your phone too. Like
yeah, you don't have to
mm-hmm. I'm always on my phone, so like mine is better on the phone because I might look for the book that I wrote down. So having it on my phone is better. My tip is actually like scheduling. Scheduling ahead of time, because it's much more difficult to shoot a video when you have on a company with like multiple people, because we have different schedules. So the time I'm available is not the time both of them are available, especially mm-hmm. like this one. I don't know where she went the night, so it's like, you know,
I'm on my bed.
Only God knows
that she don't see me.
Only God knows that, like, you know, she has a window in her room, so. Scheduling is more of like the most important one.
Yeah.
So like as I was saying, if you run the business, especially with multiple people mm-hmm. you have to make a schedule. Like, okay, Saturday morning we're going to shoot around 12 p.m. so that way everybody knows ahead of time it's like 12 p.m. We're very guilty of that actually. Like, we don't schedule. Sometimes when we schedule, we come back and we're very tired. So we just mm-hmm. we say, you know what, let's do another day. We procrastinate, and you know, and sometimes when we decide to shoot the video, one person is looking tired and the other person is like being lazy and complaining. So we just so yeah, schedule things ahead of time. Even when you're tired, you have to like get the energy from somewhere somehow. If it's playing music, you get your energy from, and just push through it. You know, that's the sacrifice you have to pay about building an empire. It's not just like doing it when you have the time, like, and when you feel like it. It's the days you don't feel like it, you have to do it anyways. Yeah. So that's my tip.
Yeah.
And even with like the scheduling, it's also like keeping each other accountable. Like she said, yeah, like two people might be ready and then the other person is like, or something comes up
right.
and then the third person, and then we're like, oh, it's three of us in this business, like we don't want to shoot a video or do something, just that's two of person. Us
yeah.
And then it's like you have to reschedule, and now with our schedule being so different,
very
you have
different.
To like, it might take like another month or so for everybody's schedule
to
align again. So it's like, and then, and another tip that we actually just learned of recently is like with the videos that we shoot, is shooting multiple videos when you have the time. So for example, like if you guys, it happens that you have a day off and everybody's day off match,
mm-hmm.
you like, you shoot multiple videos that day, and that way you just gradually post them.
Mm-hmm.
Because maybe you might not be available for the next 3 months or so.
Right.
But then you already have like 2 to 3
content,
videos already
them,
that
yeah.
you can be posting of, or even if it's taking pictures that you do, or making whatever it is that you do, you could do multiple at a time and then gradually just release.
Release.
You don't have to like do it now and then post it. You can do it in advance and then like post it up. And then when you have multiple people, even though the downside is like everybody's schedule aligning, but the good part is that you can you can share the task. I forgot the word that it is now. Division of labor, you could share the task. Like sometimes you could delegate, right? Right, see, she's
fresh out of the oven, so she knows what she's
talking about. Yeah, you can delegate. We have like certain events that we have to go to, and it's like all of us cannot make it. Like we have other commitments that we have to go to. So what we do is that we delegate. Okay, you Blessing, go to this event, and Rosie is gonna go to this event. We have the fashion show coming up. I'm not able to make a lot of the casting and the rehearsals and things like that. So Rosie has been taking that up and
holding
that. Her head will start to sweat out. So it's like you share the task, where, you know, that's the beauty of when it's more than one person. It's like a lot of things get done because you share it. Hopefully those people that you're sharing it to are accountable, and we get it done, you know, and it doesn't fall apart.
One thing I do like too is that, like, in addition to everything else, I like that we're flexible with each other. Because sometimes, like, people get caught up in, oh, this was supposed to be done and it's not done, like, and it causes a problem. Mm-hmm. So it's important to be flexible, to adapt to times and things come up and life happens. Mm-hmm. So it's important not to be a stickler to your habits and your routines and your schedules and your whatever. Just, like, communicate and just work together as a team, and it's gonna happen.
Another one that I just thought of is also like rewarding yourself and taking some time off. I know that I said the business is 24 hours, you know, 7 days a week, but it's just having that mindset of that's how you gotta work your business. You know, even if sometimes we're up at 2 a.m., 3 a.m., talking about business ideas, business products, and things like that. But it's also knowing that you don't wanna kill yourself. Like, you can't work your business if you're in the hospital.
Take care of that vessel.
Take care of yourself. So it's like if you have to, you know,
you need go downtime.
You know, downtime for, shop. Well, don't take downtime for like a week or, you know.
No, just a couple of hours or a whole day.
Yeah, so just, you know, taking downtime and rewarding yourself, no matter how your business is doing,
shopping.
Reward yourself with, like, you know, keep yourself going. And just keep it going like that, just so that, you know, you are refreshed and you don't get overwhelmed.
You don't get burned out.
You don't get burned out, yeah.
If you guys have any other tips that you feel like will be helpful to business owners, just feel free to drop the comments, because, you know, every day is a learning experience. You never know who will learn from what. So share some tips with us and send in more questions. We like the questions that we're actually getting on our social media platform at July Fashion 17. So feel free to send more.
That's IG, by the way.
Yes, that's of course. So just send in more questions, more comments, what you want to see next, and, you know, hopefully, you know, we learn from each other.
Thank you guys.
Thank you guys for watching.
We'll see you guys next time.
Bye.
Bye.